Friends, this is I am Anil Rajimwale, and today we are going to talk on the political economy of Corona crisis. As we all know that we are going through a long period of lockdown. Due to corona infection in our country and in fact all over the world, it is necessary that we take precautions. Lockdown is one of the measures taken to protect us, to prevent the spread of corona virus, which has taken such pandemic, as it is known today, proportions all over the world. It is necessary for any government, central and state, and governments of various countries to take precautions, and as far as they are effective, we definitely support those measures and cooperate with it. As we all know, a large number of people have died because of corona infection all over the world. As per the latest reports, some 3 lakh deaths have occurred in the world out of 4 million casualties, or rather cases. And it is being told by experts that these figures are underestimates. In US alone, 1.3 million cases have been reported and 80,000 people have died. In advanced Western countries, more than 30,000 deaths have taken place, each in UK, Italy, Spain, France, and a few other countries. In our country, it has already touched 2000. China was the first country to go through the severe crisis. Scientists and experts are still investigating. As per the nature and spread of the virus, researches are still going on. There is no final word, and we people who are not experts, people like me who are not experts in virus, we are unable to give any final opinion. We hope that the scientists and experts are able to provide us certain final pictures about the nature of corona and the drugs and ways to counter it, to kill it, and to save the humanity. As everybody knows, the coronavirus disease, known as COVID-19, began from Wuhan in China. China has largely controlled it. Unfortunately, it has to be stated that China was late in responding and late in reporting also. And it is thought that it has spread, it has originated from the wet market, maybe the market for killing various animals to eat, or it has come from US-China military exercises that took place before this spread, which took place near Wuhan, or all sorts of accusations and theories and hypotheses are being made. It's difficult to say. perhaps China should have warned the world more seriously and taken early measures. Now they are admitting certain mistakes. Now the problem and question is that why it has spread so much, and why so many people have been affected all over the world, particularly in the advanced Western countries. That is a moot question. Why so many deaths? It is being said that there was Spanish flu in 1918, and that also killed millions. But we are not, that was 1918. We are in 2018. It is an era of new technology. The most advanced technologies are available, particularly in the advanced industrial countries. It is an age of information revolution. It is an age where advanced scientific researches are being carried out, including in the field of viruses. And yet, so many people, such large numbers, have died even in advanced industrial countries. So, there appears to be a certain pattern in the whole thing. It is very difficult to reach a final conclusion, but definitely certain patterns are there, and we will today in this lecture try to trace those patterns or that pattern. And that is why we have talked about political economy of it. Has it been allowed to spread? Is there certain design? I'm not saying conspiracy, but some desire to allow it to develop in certain direction. There does some seem to be certain trends. Question arises, why no vaccine? Why there are no drugs? Lot of hullabaloo was raised on hydroxychloroquine. President Trump even threatened India, and India surrendered despite the ban in our country on this drug. Huge shipments were made to the US from India of this drug. And now the papers are saying that it is ineffective, and new drugs are being sought to be developed. New names are coming which are supposed to be more effective, like Remdesivir and certain other drugs. Even drugs like Azithromycin are being said to be effective. So nothing is final. Nothing is clear. Why it is so? Now here I want to mention one thing. While there is no drug, there is no vaccine, yet there are massive, big, large companies, laboratories, universities, government departments, which are carrying on researches in various kinds of drugs and pharmaceuticals. Drugs and pharmaceuticals industry business is one of the largest in the world. $1.2 lakh crore business, of which $40 billion for vaccine research alone are being used. And yet there is no vaccine so far. Coronavirus is not very new. It was already known in 2018. It was known more in 2019. Why these large business houses have not taken up research and development of these drugs? 80% of sales in vaccine field belongs to two companies alone, Pfizer and Merck. Yet, they have not been able to produce any vaccine. So this raises questions as to whether they are really serious about it. So that means the drug cartels are not interested, because this virus involves more, these drugs and vaccines involve more expenditure and less profit. That is the main reason why plasma therapy was not used, which has been used successfully with good results in Kerala. It is not unknown in the West. So there is a wider economic interest involved, wider economic meaning involved, implications involved in this. And that wider economic implication takes us to what is known as, what has come to be known as trade war between the US and China, US and Russia, US and Saudi Arabia, US and European Union countries broke out a few years ago. It was practically a war for trade, war for markets of various commodities, war to control profits, and so on. This trade war is of such dimensions that it has been compared to the Great Depression, the historic Great Depression of 1929-33. It is proving to be even bigger. And coronavirus has become a weapon of this war. Today, corona, that small microscopic organism, which is somewhere between non-living and living, an intermediate organic chemical, a transitional living thing, virus, that micro being, that coronavirus, has become a massive and effective weapon for this new kind of world war. And it is making stronger nations, particularly the US, stronger in this war, in this struggle. As we all know, the US suffered a huge crisis, a financial crisis in the year 2008. Five giant financial houses collapsed in the course of one night, creating ripples all over the world. Almost simultaneously, in last 10 years or so, a massive oil crisis has taken place. Oil is the largest commodity market in the world, that we have to understand. Corona is causing crisis for oil producing countries in the Middle East and elsewhere. Corona is going to change the global economic scenario forever. The relations between the countries, nations, economies, and people are going to change completely. What is the nature of this oil crisis, and how it is related with corona crisis, we will see in a moment. Oil prices were at $114 per barrel in the year 2014. They crashed within 2 years in 2016 to $27 only per barrel, from $114 per barrel to $27 per barrel. What was the result? How did it fare in the economy? That was the time when it was used by Indian government and the monopoly financial interests that stands behind this government to collect massive super profits through the excise duties, through special duties, through imposing various kinds of cess. So while all over the world the oil prices were falling and falling rapidly, in India and certain other countries the oil, the petrol and diesel prices were rising. Today for every liter of petrol 33 rupees of excise duty and for diesel 32 rupees of excise duty are being added, resulting in huge revenues for Ambanis and Adanis. From excise alone 1.6 lakh crores of rupees of revenue will accrue not only to the government, but government will be using, obviously it has been using, in the interests of super business houses like Ambanis and Adanis and many others. So in the course of crisis, it is the people who lose, but the finance capital does not lose. That is the point that is to be noted here. Now I will give another example of how the financial houses are gaining out of this period of crisis that we are going through in the year 2020. The US firm known as Vista Equity has bought 2.3% stake in the Jio. Well-known Jio, everybody knows it in this country. At $1.5 billion. It is the third deal within the last 3 weeks through which RIL, Reliance Industries, has raised $8 billion. The Vista Equity will pay $1.5 billion or in rupee terms $11,367 will be received by the RIL. That is finance capital for you in the course of in the period of this huge crisis for the people, for economy, for government and for entire nation and the country. Saudi Arabia's $320 billion sovereign wealth fund is exploring, just now exploring, the prospects of investment in Jio. So it is the situation of Jio and Maro. Jio for some people, for a handful, and Maro situation for vast masses. Now the oil crisis has reached a position where it has been termed the situation of price inversion. Prices are not rising, prices are going down. Negative prices have come up. The crude oil, for example, West Texas crude has turned negative. Minus $40.32 per barrel. Earlier it was minus 37 per barrel on 20th April 20. There is a place called Cushing in Oklahoma in the United States. It is a massive, perhaps the most massive store of oil in the world. It is unable to take in any more oil. It is overflowing with oil. and 104 oil tankers are standing on the shores or near the shores waiting to be offloaded, and the prices are crashing. Whiting Petroleum Corporation of the US has declared bankruptcy. Sometimes don't think that when corporation goes bankrupt, it is in a loss. Sometimes they declare bankruptcy to get rid of most of the expenses. Canadian oil has reached $0 per barrel. In this same period, enormous wealth is accumulating in US oil companies. So, what is the result? The result is that 50 million jobs are at risk. Oil and corona crisis are coinciding. And it is for this reason that the United States government is not interested at all in controlling corona. The US government has not taken any initiative. Whatever initiative has been taken is taken by local organizations, local administration, people themselves and all that. The US president is asking the people to violate the lockdown in certain states of United States run by the Democrats. In the United States, in New York, nobody follows lockdown. They are being forced time to time without result to follow the laws of lockdown. There has been no serious measures. US is the richest country in the world. It has a massive medical service, yet not much has been done to contain the spread of corona. And the US president goes on to say that yes, so many people have died. When 30,000 people died, so many people have died, it will reach 70,000. The number will reach 1 lakh, as if it is just some casual thing, like a casual in a casual way. The US president is talking about the deaths from corona. Who have died? The most common people, the poor in United States, the homeless. There are lakhs of homeless in United States, and today there are many more lakhs rendered homeless. There are long queues which are becoming longer, both on their feet and in cars, in front of the soup kitchens. Pictures have been published. No drugs. They have not been able to find out any drugs which will be effective in containing corona. Production is already down. It has been allowed to go down. No investment is taking place. No preventive measures have taken place. And yet the process of financialization continues unabated in the United States and in the other advanced Western capitalist countries. Italy, Spain, UK, France, Germany, etc. All those countries have big numbers of deaths, as you all know. There have been difficulties. But why the numbers have been allowed to reach this number, this level? Initially in these countries, hardly any steps were taken. Things were taken very lightly. The tourists from Western industrial advanced countries, they went to different countries like India, Southeast Asia and other countries. They carried, knowingly, unknowingly, the coronavirus. So the whole question has been dealt with in a very casual manner, very light-hearted manner, at the cost of humanity and humanism. this is in stark contrast. These are the contrasts of the present crisis. This is in stark contrast to the growing and deepening economic, humanitarian, social, political crisis. Blame game continues. United States is blaming China. China is blaming United States. The US has introduced what is known as the conditions of blockade against Iran, and the latest against Russia. So the retaliatory economic measures are increasing, and as a result, it is the common people who are suffering. And therefore, corona crisis combined with oil crisis and the economic crisis that began in the United States has created an unprecedented situation on this earth. It is the working class, it is the working people who are suffering most, particularly the migrant people. It is the middle class which is suffering, which is without employment today in growing numbers, including in United States. In the United States, the unemployment has reached 20%. It may be more than this number. The small and medium and other industries have simply shut down. Capitalism is eating capitalism. Finance capital is destroying industrial capital, because finance capital is not interested in development of small, medium and big industrial capitalism. This is the logic of finance capital today. This is happening in India today on a vast scale, and this is also happening in United States and other advanced capitalist countries. This is a very serious thing. It is worse than corona. Once the lockdown is out, the industries will face problems. The people will face problems. The small scale industries will face problems. They don't have capital to invest. They don't have labor. They don't have raw materials. Their labor is on the streets. I think the people of this country never before knew that there are so many hundreds of thousands, lakhs, millions of migrants who are walking from state to state, thousands of miles and kilometers, on cycles, on autos, on trucks, somehow to reach their homes, somehow to find something to eat. It is worse than a war situation. This question, this problem of migrant labor, this question of working class as the basis of society, working class, workers' labor as the base of industrial activity, construction activity, railway activity, and so on, has been underlined as never before in modern history. All because of a microvirus known as coronavirus and its mishandling mainly by finance capital. Did they not know that the migrant labor could have been transported in the trains at the very beginning of the crisis, in February itself, in March itself? One need not be an expert to understand this thing. They could have been transported. Raw materials could have been transported. Food could have been transported. Our warehouses, granaries are overflowing, and yet people are not getting food. They are rotting. Vegetables are rotting. Things are being destroyed. These steps could have been taken up earlier. As a result, most tragic and inhuman accidents are taking place which never took place earlier on such a vast scale. It underlines the serious social crisis and serious ideological and philosophical crisis in our society. It is good that a large number of NGOs, self-help groups, other organizations, political parties, mass organizations, including All India Youth Federation, have taken up relief work. It goes to their credit. But despite certain measures by this government and certain other governments, most of the problems have been ignored, resulting in death, confusion, rioting, and so on and so forth, crowding. Most of the urban population lives in slums. Is it not known? Should not the slums have been dealt with earlier, at the very beginning of the crisis? So, these are the questions that are being raised again and again. Labor as the base of economy has been underlined and highlighted. It is good that today everybody knows that there are more than 40 crores of casual, daily and migrant workers in this country. Now, this government is facing economic crisis, very serious economic crisis. It is going to borrow 54% of its fiscal deficit. That will be 12 lakh crores from the market borrowing. We hope that this will be used. But on the basis of past experience, we know that this government wastes money. It has taken money to the tune of lakhs of crores of rupees earlier from the RBI. What is the guarantee that this money is going to be used to contain the problems and solve the problems of the people as a result of corona crisis? So this is a crisis not only of labor, it is a crisis of capital itself. Both capital as well as labor are in crisis. And as far as economy is concerned, non-financial, non-monopoly sections of economy along with labor have to face this crisis together. The government is planning, I warn, a disinvestment of public sector this year to the tune of 2.1 lakh crore rupees worth. This is the disinvestment being planned in the name of coronavirus crisis. Our rate of growth, GDP, is going to crash. According to Moody's estimate, it is going to be in financial crisis 2021. GDP rate will be zero. Using this corona crisis, longer work hours are going to be introduced. Labor and industrial laws are going to be suspended, practically converting the workers into forced slavery, because they will have no other way except to work those hours for a pittance, because they will get much less salary, and because the purchasing power is almost disappeared. So there will be a serious crisis as never before. European economies are going to shrink. According to data that has emerged in the papers, the whole of European economy is going to shrink by 7.4%. So rate of growth will be -7.4%. Certain European advanced industrial countries will shrink by -9.5%, like Greece, like Italy. Certain other countries by -8.5%, like Germany. And so on, 7.5%, 6.5%, 5.5%, all in minus. So European economy and world economy is going to shrink very rapidly, consequent upon the corona crisis. And therefore, friends, this is a very serious crisis. This is a crisis of economic. This is a crisis of political economy, because a political will to solve the economic problems is lacking. This is a social crisis, because vast sections and classes, middle class, small and medium entrepreneurs, workers, peasants, they don't know where to go. They don't have any economy left. They left their villages to work in the industrial areas. Now they have come back or coming back to a place where there is no work and no protection. So peasants, small producers, all these sections, intelligentsia, students, youth, who have no work and who are going to have no work, who are losing whatever work is there. So all the sections of the people are suffering very deeply. This is not just corona crisis. This is an economic crisis. This is a crisis of political lack of will. This is a crisis of trust. This is a crisis of confidence. This is an ideological crisis. This is a philosophical crisis. An anti-humanistic philosophy is in operation. And this is a crisis for entire humanity, except a handful. This is a crisis of environment. Environment has lashed back, is lashing back. And everybody can see how it is lashing back, how it is teaching the human beings not to cross the line, not to cross the limits. So this is the crisis of ecology, ecological crisis. Crisis of climate has been underlined. Today the United States, which was a country which once advocated world economy, globalization and WTO, same United States, 2 decades later or 3 decades later today, is criticizing, is attacking the world economy. It is attacking the developing nations. It is accusing the developing nations for its own troubles, for the troubles of the United States, saying that the developing countries are responsible for the crisis, for the economic and other crisis in the United States. So the logic of finance capital has taken one complete turn, and this also shows the positive side. It shows the positive side in this, that till recently the rate of growth of developing countries have been 2 to 3 times, even 4 times more than certain Western economies, United States, Germany, France, Britain, and so on, Italy, Greece, Portugal, Spain. And therefore, particularly United States feels that somehow the developing countries should be suppressed through wars, through pressures, economic, political, ideological, others, through blockade, through arms and nuclear blackmail, by destroying small nations in various places, particularly in the Middle East and Latin America, where they tried to stage a military revolt in Venezuela and other countries too. So they are trying to suppress the developing countries, to blackmail them, to shut down their economies, to destroy their economies by following a new policy of protectionism by following economic, political, military blackmail. So military and oil are two most profitable business, and hence the military blackmail and oil blackmail and other kinds of blackmails are being used. Corona blackmail is part and parcel of that weapon of the war declared by United States imperialism and its finance capitalist logic, finance capitalist system on the world. It is a finance capital which has to be controlled. It is a parasitic capital. It is a capital which is not a capital. It is speculative capital. And therefore, all the sections of the society, workers, peasants, small and medium producers, students, youth, intelligentsia, entrepreneurs, all sections have to come together. There is a good, proper, relevant slogan has emerged in United States itself, 99% against 1%. This is really the crisis for 99% caused by less than 1% of the section of world society known as finance capital. We have to build a broad, vast, broadest possible platform and united front against of the people, against the finance capital. Only then, and finance capital has to be certain restrictions have to be adopted on way to its elimination of its domination, its parasitic domination over the world economy, only by establishing such a healthy, democratic, vast, broad democratic front can this crisis and other crises that we are going to face can be solved and faced. With these words, I finish my small presentation. Thank you for listening very patiently. Thank you very much. Finish.